Good morning, viewers. It's a new day. Welcome to today's devotion on Open Heavens Daily Devotional Study Channel, a platform that brings you the Open Heavens Devotional of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. Invite your family and friends. Get your Bible even as we read along today.
Today's date, Sunday, June 25th, 2023. Topic: Spiritual Superiority. Memory Verse, Deuteronomy 4 verse 24. For the Lord thy God is a consuming fire, even a jealous God. Bible reading is taken from 2 Kings 6 verse 15 to 23. And when the servant of the man of God was risen early, and gone forth, behold, a host compassed the city both with horses and chariots. And his servant said unto him, Alas, my master! How shall we do? 16. And he answered, Fear not, for they that be with us are more than they that be with them. 17. And Elisha prayed, and said, Lord, I pray thee, open his eyes, that he may see. And the Lord opened the eyes of the young man, and he saw, and, behold, the mountain was full of horses and chariots of fire round about Elisha. 18. And when they came down to him, Elisha prayed unto the Lord, and said, Smite these people, I pray thee, with blindness. And he smote them with blindness according to the word of Elisha. 19. And Elisha said unto them, This is not the way, neither is this the city. Follow me, and I will bring you to the man whom ye seek. But he led them to Samaria. 20. And it came to pass when they were come into Samaria, that Elisha said, Lord, open the eyes of these men, that they may see. And the Lord opened their eyes, and they saw, and, behold, they were in the midst of Samaria. 21. And the king of Israel said unto Elisha, When he saw them, My father, shall I smite them? Shall I smite them? 22. And he answered, Thou shalt not smite them. Wouldest thou smite those whom thou hast taken captive with thy sword and with thy bow? Set bread and water before them, that they may eat and drink, and go to their master. 23. And he prepared great provision for them, and when they had eaten and drunk, he sent them away, and they went to their master. So the bands of Syria came no more into the land of Israel. Our topic once again is spiritual superiority. Message: Spiritual superiority is what can make you deal with your enemies so completely that you make a mockery of them. This is what happened in Colossians 2 verse 15, which says, And having spoiled principalities and powers, he made a show of them openly, triumphing over them in it. 2 Kings 6 verse 8 to 20 tells us that a king considered Elisha as a threat, so he sent an entire army to arrest him. This, however, turned out to be an impossible mission because Elisha demonstrated spiritual superiority by arresting the entire army when they got to his place. As if that was not enough, he also led them as captives into their enemy's territory. When God sees a man or woman who is committed to a life of holiness, he will use that fellow to make an open shame of the enemy and arrest arresters. If you get really close to God, you won't pray for your enemies to be destroyed, because the Bible says in Psalm 23 verse 5, Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies, thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. If all enemies are dead, who will behold your glory? I am praying for you that God will take you to such a level that in the very presence of your enemies, he will be glorified in you, in Jesus' name. Your ability to exhibit spiritual superiority over the devil happens when you become really close to God. How close do you want to be to God, the consuming fire? The elders say that when a leaf stays long with the soap, it will become soap. If you stay sufficiently close to the consuming fire, you too will become a consuming fire. If you really want to be able to put your enemies to shame, then you need to get close to the consuming fire. The price to pay for this is complete holiness and constant fellowship with God. Fasting and prayers must be your lifestyle. Without holiness, you cannot even have access to the Lord, and talk less of being close to Him. Leave holy and you will see the enemy begging you to release them after you have arrested them. Key point. When you get sufficiently close to the consuming fire, you will also become a consuming fire against your enemies. Key point. When you get sufficiently close to the consuming fire, you will also become a consuming fire against your enemies. Bible in 1 year, Psalm 112-118. Our hymn today is hymn 23. Take my life and let it be. Have a great day. See you tomorrow. God bless you.
Take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to Thee. Take my moments and my days, let them flow in ceaseless praise. Take my hands and let them move at the impulse of Thy my feet and let them be swift and beautiful for Thee. Take my voice and let me sing, always only for my King. Take my lips and let them filled with messages from me. Take my silver and my gold, not a mite would I withhold. Take my intellect and use every power as you choose. Here